Hello, everybody. My name is Jonathan Levi. I didn't really spend a lot of time making the presentations, but I do have three slides. So just background about what I did and how I got into kind of the blockchain space before starting working almost full-time on Hyperledger. So initially, I worked on a Bitcoin exchange, and we started working on basically what we call the complex derivatives. The idea was that you have a portfolio of investment, and if you want to buy into some investment in terms of like buying into some Apple shares, we're going to be able to replicate that and let you buy some stuff without holding them. So it was kind of a synthetic portfolio that you can just buy and transfer value as you like. We worked with the SEC for like 2 years, full time. We even had the former head of the SEC on our board of advisors. It didn't go anywhere. We spent 2 years trying to get like a no action letter. Then I realized, okay, the problem is actually bigger. We, instead of just trying to come up with something that makes sense to us and trying to convince the regulators how to get it to work, why don't we just try to build stuff? At the same time, Vitalik and the Ethereum guys came up with Frontier, which was Ethereum 1.0. We started working with that. I was at Stanford at the time, so I kind of worked on the first, we created like the first Ethereum class, the cryptocurrency class at Stanford. After that, I just basically dropped out of my PhD. I worked with Dan Bonet before and started a company that is trying to do something very simple. I looked at the cryptocurrency space, and I really like blockchain, and I really like Merkle trees, and I'm a cryptographer kind of by training. And at the same time, I was also a banker for like 10 years. So it was always easy for me to look at everything from kind of the crypto side, because it's so cool, and we can do all the cool stuff and all the fancy stuff that you want to do in crypto. But at the same time, if I put my kind of banker's hat on, I know that we cannot like move this stuff around, right? So when Ethereum came up with this super open network, my main concern, and I gave a lot of kind of lectures about it, and I was always talking about this in all these events, we have like three problems. All the stuff that we do with KYC, AML, so know your customer, all the stuff that we need to do in terms of anti-money laundering. If I have to do any global payment or cross-border asset transfer, there are so many jurisdictions and rules and legal stuff that is associated with it. So if we are building a system that is kind of based only on censorship resistance, or me having a smart contract somewhere in a way that I will not be able to stop it, it's a nice use case and it's great, but it's not enough. What I was always thinking of is how can we get kind of the mainstream, kind of, let's call it enterprise as well, to buy into the technology. And then at the same time, I gave a talk at the it was NYU, and I talked about like, okay, look, I really like kind of the Ethereum, and I really like the kind of the whole kind of decentralization and Bitcoin for sure, because I was like early on, like I don't know, it was 2011 when I started this. But at the same time, if I put my back inside, I know that we cannot go anywhere without all this stuff. At the same time, Hyperledger kind of started, and people approached me and said, look, we buy into the whole thing. Would you like to help? And I'm like, oh, I like talking about like what I don't like. I don't like doing stuff. But we started consulting to IBM Research, and we started working with Hyperledger Fabric. So I was kind of really very early in the contribution to Fabric. It was 0.5. That was the first release. Moved up in the world to do kind of 0.5, 0.6, I became the release manager of Hyperledger Fabric 1.0. But effectively, I helped shape, like the biggest contribution that I had to Hyperledger Fabric was to help shape kind of the membership services. Today, I sit on the TSC, we run a company, we're an ISV or to IBM, we're an independent solution vendor. So we would do a lot of stuff with, actually, Hyperledger Fabric, I do a lot of stuff with DID, the decentralized identity, that we have also in Hyperledger. We worked a lot with Ethereum, so we basically are a company that is trying to be like blockchain agnostic, so we don't want to lock you in. We add tokens to Fabric, so we can support payments. We can give you user management. It works between different blockchains. So if you have an account in Ethereum and you would like to actually onboard a client onto a Fabric network, it's very easy. We do a lot of stuff with IntelliJ, so we can connect different blockchains. So if you want to move kind of assets from one chain to another, we can do it with, you know, this kind of two atomic swaps and stuff. It's very simple, but it's actually very effective. But our kind of, if you look at like where we want to see ourselves, we would like to be like the blockchain company that basically is trying to do the cool stuff while still complying and working with regulations and working with the big guys. And we are in a position that we can easily do kind of the cool things, but still bring like the IBM cloud to your solution, still work with Oracle, still work with Microsoft Azure. So we don't lock you in into kind of building something that is very proprietary. It's all open source. We work with different projects, but we really believe in interoperability. And I don't think the tokens are bad. I just think that people need to be very careful about what they promise and who they're selling to. And you do need KYC, AML, and all this user management in place. So, yeah, that's us.